bit of a mod. I got Carla here. She's with me. She's gonna man
the V-Box. But I added a torque converter lock.
And what that basically is gonna do is give us the ability to lock up the torque converter as soon as we launch. So that way we don't have any slip in that 1-2 shift. It should make the shift a lot cleaner. So I'm gonna give it a try. We'll see how it does. I'm hoping to see a little bit of a reduction in the 0-60 from that. If we get another, say, 2-3 tenths, that'd be great. Best we were able to do before was a 6.7. So, Carl, you wanna take the camera
here? Yeah, you can go down, there's no traffic.
All right, so let's get out, let's put it in four wheel high. Box is set. There we go. This is gonna be a boosted launch. Ready?
Let's do it.
Here we go.
Jeez.
Good.
Yeah, that was like solid.
But I felt it still, that 1-2 shift is still sluggish. So the torque converter mod works, but that 1-2 shift is no good. So what we've got coming is a valve body from 1023 diesel. And hopefully that valve body will help us out, because I don't think that this is gonna, I don't think this transmission is gonna want that extra power when we put that turbo in. So we have the turbo coming, we got a valve body coming. I'll try another one just to see if it gets any better. Try again, you ready?
Ready.
There, torque converter lock ready, here we go. That 1-2 shift is killing us, but the good old boy will be back for more. Guys, Memorial Day weekend, it's raining. For about 3 days straight, it's been raining. The yard's been doing good. Didn't get any flooding. I saw a little bit of standing water over in here last night, but nothing that didn't drain out. This arena has got water all over it. So, I mean, I don't know how much rain we've gotten exactly, but it is extraordinary. I would say probably at least 12 to 13 inches at least. I mean, we just got a ton of rain over the last 3 days. And there's really not too much you can do about that down here because we're at sea level. So the rain just kind of starts to saturate the ground. And after that, it starts to sit. But either way, we've been doing pretty good so far. But one that didn't do too good was the good old boy. So the good old boy is my Power Stroke diesel truck. And with all this rain, I noticed it was starting to get water inside in the cab. And I was like, what the hell? And I thought it was the dreaded windshield seal leak. So I started to look around under the dash. I noticed my speedometer started acting funky and a couple of other things started happening, which were not right. And it turns out there was water in the fuse box and I heard it like sizzling. So I know what you're thinking, Jack had a fire. No fire, luckily. But I did track down the problem, and it was the visor that was on top, that great visor that everyone hates so much. And I'm really upset about it, but I had to take it off. So now the good old boy doesn't have its visor anymore. I had to take the visor off because there was holes in the roof that were just dumping water in. I had no idea. So I had to plug those holes up with some sealant. Shame. There's the visor over here. I'm not going to throw it away yet, but I might have to. Either way, good old boy got a haircut. I think he looks all right. And now, no more leak. I tested overnight. Nice and dry. I dried out the fuse box. I took it all apart, put dielectric grease on everything, and that fixed it. So, oh well. But hopefully this week, you know, today's a holiday, so no mail today. But hopefully this week we get the big turbo for the good old boy. It's on the way, as well as a valve body. We're going to try and fix that shifting. That 1-2 is not good. And I know that that's the reason why the 0 to 60 got a little slower. The lockup switch for the converter is awesome. It works really well. And from like a low first gear roll, when you mash that button and floor it, oh boy, the tires break loose. So I know that that's working. It's getting more power to the ground, but the tranny's not happy with that. So hopefully the valve body tightens up that 1-2. We'll see. Hopefully the transmission itself is not damaged. Wouldn't surprise me though with how much abuse we're putting through this thing. So let's see what happens when we get that valve body. I want to see that 1-2 firm up nice. That's going to drop the 0 to 60 significantly. I think that will be down in the low sixes where we need to be, considering lockup. And then with the turbo, we should be able to get a little bit more boost, because right now we're hitting about 25 pounds. I'd like to see over 30, maybe even 35. We'll see if we can get the boost up. We get that boost up, that eats up all the fuel we could possibly be dumping with the stock injectors. And then obviously we upgrade to the bigger injectors. So 1023 diesel is sending me the valve body and the turbo. We're also going to get rid of the back pressure valve, which is in the turbo pedestal. So that gets rid of this exhaust brake that's in the back. It's in the rear end of the turbo, and it closes and creates back pressure. So we're going to get rid of that. So that's a useless feature on this truck for me. That'll free up a little bit more flow, and it'll give us the ability to make a little more boost in power. It'll flow a little better. So more air and fuel in, more power out. That's the name of the game. So we'll get that installed. The guys next door at Lox Diesel are going to help me install that. We're also going to take care of the exhaust leak. It has an exhaust leak in one of the up pipes. So we've identified that. I didn't really notice it, but if you look back in one of my videos when I was all-wheel drive launching, or four-wheel drive boosted launching against Rudnick, you can see a cloud of smoke coming out from under the engine area. It's not supposed to be there. It's supposed to be at the exhaust pipe, the tailpipe. And that's because the exhaust leak under the hood was allowing that soot to escape right there under load. And that's how I figured out we have an Elite. Well, you can hear it too a little bit. I didn't know for sure because I've never had one of these trucks, but you could hear the exhaust leak. So new up pipes coming. We're going to fix that at the same time when we put the turbo in and the turbo pedestal. Those items together should make a significant difference, I think, in the spool up as well as the total power that we're producing. We'll probably pick up a little bit and hopefully get the good old boy back where she needs to be. And then the valve body. So let's see how that goes. The guys at 1023 have been really pushing me in the right direction with this truck. I'm really happy with that. And if you have a 7.3 and you want to go faster also, don't hesitate to give them a call. They've got this down. They know what's up. And most of the problems that I'm having, they literally told me about before I even mentioned it. So not really big stuff, not bad problems, just the little quirks of the old grandpa truck that you have to be aware of. All right, I'm going to go survey this farm and see how much water we've got standing. Obviously, standing water is not good for the horses, so we don't want that. But Memorial Day weekend, 2020, I'm not surprised. 2020's been a bummer. Well, not that bad. We got the good old boy. We got the tractors. You know, there's something we can do here. We'll figure out something. Happy Memorial Day to you guys. Stay tuned for more. Backyard's looking kind of swamped. Starting to get smushy here. I'm not going to get out there too far, but quite a bit of water. The rain stopped though, so that's good. So this should drain off pretty quick, but just to give you an idea of what kind of water we got. That's intense. Tractors are high and dry.